Are we good? We're good? Yeah? So before we begin, if the vehicles in the A parking lot, if you wouldn't mind staying off the live feed to give us some more bandwidth, we would appreciate it. And we'll get on with the ceremony. Thank you. And you can tune into the radio in order to listen to the proceedings here. 87.7. If someone can give me a honk if you just heard me out there. Thank you. I now welcome Ms. Joanne Ampey.
Our home and native land, true patriot love, in all thy sons command, with glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Mr. Bird, one of the VPs here at Fort Francis High School, and will be your MC tonight for this evening. I want to thank Ms. Hines and the Fort Francis High School Band, and also Ms. Joanne Ampey. I want to acknowledge that we are on the ancestral lands of the Anishinaabeg, and within the Treaty 3 territory, and we acknowledge the Métis, who also call this area home. We want to welcome all graduates and family to this unique ceremony to honor our 2021 graduates. To start this evening off, graduates, you may sit down. And I want to welcome our principal and leader, Ms. Leishman, to open the ceremony.
Good evening, graduates, parents, and loved ones. My name is Jen Leishman, and I consider myself very fortunate to be the principal of Fort Francis High School and have the opportunity to stand here tonight in celebration of our 2021 graduates. I'd like to welcome everyone near the football field and far, our parking lots, to our outdoor graduation ceremony. What a year it has been, and boy, do we have something to celebrate tonight. At this moment, as our ceremony is about to begin, I am so very thankful that we can all be here together celebrating one of life's most important milestones, high school graduation. As I look around, I realize how many people have worked so hard and have come together as a school community to make this happen. I cannot express how thankful we are as administration for this team at Fort Francis High School. The endless hours of planning and organizing is the only way that this could happen tonight. Thank you dearly to the teachers, EAs, custodians, and secretaries for your team effort. You are truly amazing, an amazing group of people, and Fort Francis High School is blessed to have you. There are three trees on our stage tonight. One is to honor the 215 Indigenous children that were located in Kamloops Indian Residential School. The second tree is for one of our students, Trey Thompson, who left us this year, but his humor and wit touched those who knew him. Our third tree is for Billy Drennan, who we lost in the spring. Billy was a dynamic individual, and his friends from Fort High remember and share memories that were made. I'm going to ask right now that we just take a minute to remember the loss of these children. Thank you. Parents, guardians, family members, and staff, you have all played an integral part in our graduates' lives, and you will forever be appreciated for the unconditional support that you give. Graduates, each of you should be incredibly proud of yourselves as you walk this stage tonight, and appreciate that you are surrounded by those who believed in you and what you could achieve. Thinking back to a year ago at this time, we never could have imagined that we would still be altering our graduation ceremony due to a pandemic. What I can imagine, though, are the many life lessons you have learned throughout these challenges, and how someday you will come back and understand how sometimes life's biggest challenges can end up being our biggest teachings. You have learned patience, determination, perseverance, and positivity. These four qualities can, in fact, change your course or pathway in life. How have you shown these admirable qualities? Well, let's reminisce for a minute. In September, we welcomed you back to a quadmester, moved you into specific cohorts, only allowed you to use specific washrooms with a limited number of people. You had to wear masks, understand course material taught by your teachers, who were completely masked and goggled, repeatedly request that you sanitize your hands, and that you social distance. Then March arrived. March break arrived. Well, just kidding, it actually did not arrive. But April break did come, and then we found out that we would be moving to online classes. And this is how our year ended. I remember something a colleague and friend once said to me. When something happens out of your control, you have two options. You can be negative and focus all your energy on negative thoughts, be angry, or feel like you were done wrong. Or you can try to deal with it through a positive lens and accept it. Regardless, you have no control over what has happened. But you do have control over your attitude and your outlook. Throughout all of these changes and disappointments this year, you had two choices: to be negative or angry, or to be patient and positive. You graduates chose the latter, and that is remarkable. What we as a staff want you to know is that even though we didn't have the pleasure of spending the last few months with you in person in the school, you have left an everlasting impression on us. You will be a group that will never be forgotten, and not because of COVID-19, but because of who you are as individual people, how you represented yourself through challenging times, and because of the positive attitude that you chose to have. I want to thank you tonight for your perseverance and determination. Thank you for not giving up. I know there were many times when you had to get up for class, meaning you had to sit up in your bed and turn your Chromebook or your laptop on, when all you really wanted to do was sleep. And even if you did nap here and there, you did what needed to be done to finish off your credits and be here tonight. I hope you truly realize what an accomplishment this is. Many of you held jobs, you babysat, you helped with siblings, with your siblings' schoolwork, all the while still maintaining your grades. Please, never underestimate the challenges you overcame in the last year to be here. You missed out on extracurricular activities such as sports, musicals, groups, and outdoor adventures. You could have used this as a reason to not push yourself to be here tonight, but you didn't. Shortly, you will walk across the stage and receive your diploma. Hold your head high. Do remember something, though. Sometimes life is tough, but there are people who care and love you and are there to support you. If you feel alone, always ask someone to help you out. This year has been tough at times, and do not punish yourself if you had some bad days or weeks. Tonight is about celebrating, and it's about starting the next chapter of your life. Enjoy every moment of it. Take those pictures with your family, even if it's the last thing you want to do. Reminisce about high school memories and pat yourself on the back for the amazing job you have done. You are the Fort Frances graduating class of 2021. Trust me when I say that nobody will have the stories to share like you will with your families. You will definitely trump that story that many of your family members probably tell about having to walk uphill 5 miles every day to school. Please, they have nothing on you. Enjoy your graduation, enjoy your night, and please be safe.
Thank you, Ms. Leishman. Yeah, it was a fun year for sure. I'd like now to invite Mr. Ray Calder up here for the salutatorian speech. Ray?
Thank you. Good evening, parents, family, teachers, staff, friends, and of course, the graduating class of 2021. We finally made it. We have all accomplished one of the early milestones in our lives, all while navigating a turbulent time full of uncertainty. Over the last 4 years, we've learned a lot. Mr. Fisher taught us how to factor a binomial. Mr. Spooner explained the inner workings of stoichiometry, and Mr. Michaud taught us how to swear in French. All of this knowledge, carefully instructed by our dedicated teachers, will no doubt be valuable as we go forward in life. And now, while the very nature of the subject is already becoming a cliche, I must address the elephant in the room, or rather, the field. The everlasting coronavirus pandemic has radically changed the lives of people around the world, and we will feel its effects for years to come. Our school has been back and forth between in-person and online learning, causing students and educators to adapt to entirely new teaching styles overnight. The 9th and 10th grade are the only two normal years of high school we will ever get to experience. We've missed out on so much. While I wouldn't exactly call myself an athlete, unless you count almost making it to OFSA for cross-country skiing, I know that many of my classmates felt the absence of athletics offered at Fort High, not to mention all the clubs, concerts, musicals, celebrations, dances, and more that will forever be a 10th grade memory. To put it plainly, losing the last year and a half of high school sucked. However, our perseverance and resilience throughout this pandemic will set us up to face many of life's challenges, and the future does look promising. On behalf of the graduating class, I would like to take a moment to thank all of you here today and those watching at home. Thank you to the school and our family and friends for the continuous support. It has been instrumental to our success. Although graduation is often a time to reflect on the past, it's also a time to look forward. Some are deciding to dive into their careers, others are furthering their education, and the rest are just going with the flow for now. We all have very different paths to take, which will all have their own unique rewards and challenges. If there is one important thing I've learned in my teenage years, it is to seek out discomfort. Lately, this has been challenging, as it is quite comfortable to stay at home and endlessly scroll through TikTok. However, discomfort is what led me to where I am standing at this moment. Don't ask my teachers about this, but I think I've always been a quiet kid. Over the last year, I've really made a conscious effort to be uncomfortable. I've been branching out, making new friends, even changing up my style. And I'm so grateful I did, for I've made so many memories and connections that will last a lifetime. We are about to jump headfirst into the real world. A world without mom and dad to pay the bills. A world where we must cook our own meals. And unfortunately, a world where we have to do our own laundry. This may be exceptionally challenging, since I doubt more than a handful of seniors consistently got out of bed before noon on e-learning days. Adulthood will be unforgiving and difficult at times. However, our transition into this next chapter is the last.
I welcome Ms. Leishman back up here.
So typically when we hand out the awards, it's done after the students have crossed their stage receiving their diplomas. But because we had to work in the four different groups that we have tonight, that's the reason we have to read them tonight. So I will congratulate you when it's your turn to walk across the stage, but I want to congratulate you as well as I read the names of the awards for tonight. So the Rainy River District School Board presents the following awards. The Leading Student Award is presented to a graduating student with the highest average in 6 grade 12 credits. The leading student's name is inscribed on a plaque in the atrium of the school. The recipient of the 2021 Leading Student Award is Aurora Hutton. Feel free to share with Lil Honk or celebration. Honorary academic portfolios are awarded to students who have received at least 3 certificates of merit. This year's recipients are Naomi Dunn, Joanna Empey, Erica Lemelin, Ryan McLean, and Kylie Stafford. Congratulations. The Governor General's Medal is awarded to a graduating student who has achieved the highest average in their grade 11 and 12 courses. The recipient of the 2021 Governor General's Medal is Aurora Hutton. Congratulations, Aurora. The Lenora Colvin Memorial Award is presented to a graduating student who has attained an outstanding record in attendance and academic achievement. This winner's award is Ryan McLean. Congratulations. The Robert George Memorial Award in Transportation marks a high standard in the practical application of automotive theory. This year's recipient is Jared Flatt. Congratulations, Jared. The Ralph Whetstone Trophy is for the most outstanding music student, and this year it is presented to Erica Lemelin. The Sir Isaac Newton Award is to the student obtaining the highest average on the first attempt in 4U physics and 4U calculus and vectors. The recipient is Connor Bellis. The Murray Kitts Theater Arts Award is presented to a graduating student who has made an outstanding contribution to the school's theatrical productions. The award is presented to Joanna Empey. The Lieutenant Governor's Community Volunteer Award for students pays tribute to those students who not only complete the number of volunteer hours required to graduate, but who go above and beyond. The 2021 recipient for Fort Frances High School is Naomi Dunn. Rainy River District School Board Technical Awards for Excellence are given to technical graduates in shop disciplines whose overall standing is at least second class honors. These awards will be presented to Sam Smith in Communications, Eric Grenier and Lauren Penny in Construction, Ben Loney in Manufacturing, and Jared Flatt in Transportation. Congratulations to all our award winners.
Congrats to all award winners. Thank you, Ms. Leishman. And now we're going to move on to the presentation of the Ontario Secondary School Diplomas. We will begin with Group 1. Ms. Rybuck will announce our Group 1 graduates.
Janelle Rose Allen. She is the recipient of the Fort Frances Royal Canadian Legion Scholastic Awards, the I Am Awesome Initiative Scholarship, the Jeremiah Tucker Memorial Bursary, the NCDS Making a Difference Bursary, the Royal Canadian Legion General Lipsett Branch 99 Bursary, the Claude Breer Memorial Bursary, UNFC, the Sunset Country Métis Bursary, proud to be Métis, the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program participant, and she is an Ontario scholar. Jocelyn Brooke Allen. Jocelyn is the recipient of the Fort Frances Physicians Group Bursary, the Fort Frances Royal Canadian Legion Scholastic Awards, the Royal Canadian Legion General Lipsett Branch 99 Bursary. She is a participant with the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and she is an Ontario scholar. Morgan Elizabeth Beckett. Morgan is the recipient of the ETFO Rainy River District's Teachers Local Bursary, and she is an Ontario scholar. Jay Tyrell Big George. Jay is an Ontario scholar. Luke Bird. Reese Nolan Bowles. Reese is the recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Tashi Morgan Broadbent. Joseph David Marvin Breer. Congratulations. Nate Michael John Breer. Nate is the recipient of the Specialist High Skills Major in Manufacturing certificate. Raymond Martin Brock Calder. Raymond is the recipient of the Kiwanis Bursary, the Pay It Forward Bursary Indigenous, the Peter Bond Bursary, and Raymond is an Ontario Scholar. Daphne Amanda Chabot. Daphne is an Ontario Scholar. Cheyenne Chambers. Cheyenne is the recipient of the I Am Awesome Initiative Scholarship, the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program participant, and she is an Ontario Scholar. Braden Callis Christensen. Braden is the recipient of the Seven Generations Educational Institute Outstanding Perseverance and Achievement Award, as well as the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Caden Ray Coalition. Caden is the recipient of the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program participant and a specialist high skills major in manufacturing. You ready? Okay. Jaden Zane Cooper. Jaden is the recipient of the H2O to Go Bursary, the Fort Francis High School Faculty Awards. He is also an Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program participant and an Ontario Scholar. Grayson Frederick Clare Counselor. Grayson is the recipient of the Allen Snowball Memorial Award, the ETFO Rainy River District Teachers Local Bursary. He also is receiving the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate and is an Ontario Scholar. Ashton Edward Cousineau. Ashton is the recipient of the Knights of Columbus Council 2766 Bursary. He is also receiving a specialist high skills major in health and wellness, and he is an Ontario Scholar. Keisha Dawn Rose DeBungie. Keisha is an Ontario Scholar, and she's also receiving the Fort Francis High School Leadership Award. Connor Christopher Dent. Congratulations. Jace Christian William Bradley DeTiro. Jace is the recipient of the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program participant, and he is also an Ontario Scholar. Naomi Francis Dunn. Naomi is the recipient of the Emo Thrift Store Award for Volunteerism, a Kiwanis Bursary, the Shelter of Hope Bursary. She is an Ontario Scholar. She's also receiving an honorary academic portfolio and the Lieutenant Governor's Community Volunteer Award for students.
I forgot to mention before that a big thank you goes to Rebecca Webb and CIBC for their donation of the cords tonight that we're handing out to the graduates, and they represent Perseverance. So thank you very much.
Okay, before I have the graduates exit, after the celebration, if the vehicles, the students will go to the vehicle and then in a safe and orderly manner entering out the south by the black and yellow flags there in single file. And then we just keep moving on. So congratulations, graduates. You stand up, graduates. And you can throw your caps on the count of three. One, two, three. Yeah, vehicles just wait until all graduates have made it safely to their vehicle. Okay, vehicles will exit on the south between the two flags in single file, please. Group B may start entering the field. Remember, the staff will be along the highway there, so take a left after you exit onto King's Highway. graduates. Give me a honk if the sound is good out there. All right. I wasn't sure. Okay, so welcome, graduates, family, and friends, for our group two. For this group here, we will have Miss Milne to announce our group two graduates.
Gavin Anthony Elias. Gavin is a recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Joanna Maria Empey. Joanna has received the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. She's an Ontario scholar. And has earned the Honorary Academic Portfolio and the Murray Kitts Theatre Arts Award. Greta May Gabrielle Fedoric. Greta has received the EDFO Rainy River District Teachers Local Bursary, Fort Francis Royal Canadian Legion Scholastic Awards, I Am Awesome Initiative Scholarship, St. Mary's Catholic Women's League Bursary, St. Mary's Parish Bursary, John Makarenko Memorial Bursary, and Greta is an Ontario Scholar. James Douglas Furlong. Brandon Eric Gagne. Okay. Morgan Jolie Gagne. Jackson David Lee Gartsky. Jackson is an Ontario scholar. Okay. Matthew Joseph Gerstner. Matthew has received the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Madison Cherise Gooden. Nick Lee Martin Gray. Eric Daniel Grenier. Eric has received the Fort Frances Royal Canadian Legion Scholastic Awards, Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association Bursary, Fort Frances High School Faculty Award, Fort Frances PID Bud Danilchuk Memorial Bursary. He has earned a specialist high skills major in health and wellness. Eric is an Ontario scholar and has received the Board of Education Technical Awards in Construction. Sydney Nicole Grinsell. Sydney, in the last 12 months, has earned 19 high school credits. James Leslie Hagen. James has earned the Fort Frances High School Endowment Fund Workplace Award and has been a participant in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. Maya Saranda Clara Hamilton. Maya is an Ontario scholar. Sierra Lynn Happy. Sierra is an Ontario scholar. Gabby Shaney Harp. Raya Dawn Harlack. Aurora Magdalene Hutton. Aurora has received the ETFO Rainy River District Teachers Local Bursary, Fort Frances Royal Canadian Legion Scholastic Award, Grade 12 French Award, I Am Awesome Initiative Scholarship, Royal Canadian Legion Ladies Auxiliary Branch 29 Bursary, Royal Canadian Legion Manitoba Northwestern Ontario Command District 7 Bursary. Aurora is an Ontario scholar and has also received the Leading Student Award and the Governor General's Medal. Yeah. Is it good to go? Isabella Alexandra Melanie Hyatt. Okay. Allie Mae Johnson. Allie is an Ontario scholar. Eli Dale Johnson. Eli has received the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Okay. Just stand here. Aiden Robert Cabate. Aiden has received the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Darian Lauren Joseph Clem. Darian is an Ontario scholar. Katrina Grace Cummins. Katrina has earned a specialist high skills major in health and wellness, and Katrina is an Ontario scholar.
So congratulations, graduates. I'll now ask you to stand up, please. And on the count of three, you may toss your caps. Cars may honk if they wish. I know you will. So one, two, three. Again, we ask the vehicles to exit through the south in a safe, single-file, orderly manner. Thank you. And wait for the grads to all enter into their vehicle before we start movement. Thank you. Again, I'm just reminding vehicles as you exit and enter onto King's Highway, turning left, there'll be staff there waiting to wave and congratulate your son and your daughter. D, you can start to enter the north end parking lot and be prepared to line up as our final group. Please sit down.
I want to welcome graduates, family, relatives, and friends. We'll have Mrs. Breer come up to present to announce our graduates.
Erica Lees Lemelin. Erica is a recipient of the Camillo Bellis Memorial Bursary, the Emo Thrift Store Award for Volunteerism, the International Early Iron Car Club Bursary. She is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Manufacturing. She is also a participant in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. Erica is an Ontario Scholar and a recipient of the Honorary Academic Portfolio and the Ralph Whetstone Trophy. Colton Anthony Langell. Kaylin Marie Levesque. Kaylin is a recipient of the Seven Generations Educational Institute Outstanding Perseverance and Achievement Award. She is a recipient of the Seven Generations Education Institute Bursary, the Northwest Catholic District School Board Scholarship. She is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness Program, and Kaylin is an Ontario Scholar. Benjamin Carter Loney. Benjamin is a recipient of the Specialist High Skills Major in Manufacturing Certificate. He is a participant in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. Ben is an Ontario Scholar and has received the Board of Education Technical Award in Manufacturing. Piper Wynn Lyon. Piper is a recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. There's a light up now. Sean Roderick McDonald. Sean is a recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate, and he is an Ontario Scholar. Kaylee Noel Matura. Kaylee is a recipient of the Struan Gilson Memorial Bursary. She is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness, and Kaylee is an Ontario Scholar. Abigail Ray Lynn Macklem. Hello, beautiful. You look wonderful. Star Jewel Martin. Rachel Elizabeth McCoy. Hannah Mary Rose McDermott. Hannah is a recipient of the B.E. June Smith Scholarship, the D'Agostini Bursary, the Lavarandre General Hospital Auxiliary Bursary, the Royal Canadian Legion Ladies Auxiliary Branch 29 Bursary, the Northwest Catholic District School Board Scholarship. She is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness, and Hannah is an Ontario Scholar. Congratulations. Kian John McAvoy. Kian is a recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Logan Melvin McFadden. Logan is a recipient of the Specialist High Skills Major in Manufacturing Red Seal Certificate. Congratulations, Logan. Thank you, sir. Joshua Peter McGinnis. Ryan Brooklyn Antonia McLean. Ryan is a recipient of the Fort Francis High School Students Council Leadership Award, the I Am Awesome Initiative Scholarship, the OSSTF Rainy River District 5B Award, the Pay It Forward Bursary, Rural, the Royal Canadian Legion Ladies Auxiliary Branch 29 Bursary, the Fort Francis High School Endowment Fund Merit Award. She is a Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness participant. Ryan is an Ontario Scholar. has received the Honorary Academic Portfolio, as well as the Ontario Principals Council Award for Student Leadership and the Lenora Colvin Memorial Award.
Actually, this is a really nice breeze. Yeah. Your parents are happy they're getting a photo op. We should have had some dance moves worked out. Cassie's a dancer.
Cassandra Ann Mickle. Cassandra is a recipient of the Bob Briggs Memorial Scholarship, and she's a participant in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. Gavin Lee Morisseau. Gavin is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Business and an Ontario Scholar.
Where's your mom and dad sitting? Where are they parked?
Cameron J. Mosbeck.
Congratulations. Stand here and look at the audience.
Jada Ashton Norris. Jada is an Ontario Scholar.
Congratulations, Jada.
Thank you.
You're awesome. Thank you, Mel.
Rachel Grace Neusbaumer. Rachel is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness, and she is an Ontario Scholar.
Hi, how are you? So good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Look at your peeps. Where are they? Make sure you look in their direction so they're taking your picture.
Brett Edward Gary Ogden.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Alexis Madison Michaela Parker. Lauren Rose Penny. Lauren is a participant in the Specialist High Skills major in Health and Wellness. She is an Ontario Scholar, and she is a recipient of the Board of Education Technical Award in Construction.
Way to go.
Nikki Gabrielle Picardel. Nikki is a recipient of the Pay It Forward Bursary from the Town of Fort Frances, and she's an Ontario Scholar. William Richards. William is a participant in the Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness program, and he is an Ontario Scholar.
Yeah, you can come up now. So good to see you. Where's your dad? Where's your mom? Okay. Make sure they can get a really good photo op.
Dominic Russo Kingbird. Dominic is a recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate.
Okay, congratulations, graduates. You may now stand. And on the count of three, you may toss your caps. One, two, three.
Okay, welcome graduates, family, and relatives and friends. We're saving the best for last. We're going to have Miss McKinnon announce our graduates.
Sean Michael Spook Chattal. Sean was a participant on the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. He's a recipient of the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Cameron James Schofield. Cameron is a participant in the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. Brett Allen Schramm. Jacob Ray Siemens. Jacob has a specialist high skills major in manufacturing and is a participant in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program of Fort Pye. Sam James Smith. Sam is a recipient of the Board of Education Technical Award in Communications. Kenna Lynn Spuzak. Kenna is an Ontario scholar. Kylie Mae Stafford. Kylie has a specialist high skills major in business, an Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate. She is an Ontario scholar. Kylie is a recipient of the Honorary Academic Portfolio and the Fort Frances High School Leadership Award. Kira Joan Strickland. Kira is an Ontario scholar. Logan Craig Teeple. Douglas Jean Titro.
Jean.
Harlan Ross Tuesday. Declan Ross Webb. Declan is a participant in the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program Certificate, and he is also an Ontario Scholar. Davis Christopher Willinga. Davis is a participant in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, the Aboriginal Youth Entrepreneurship Program, and he is also an Ontario Scholar. Marty Lexis Woods. Marty is a recipient of the Peter Senek Memorial Scholarship, Shirley Cribland Memorial Scholarship, the Fort Frances High School Endowment Fund Bursary, the Lyons Wilf Book Memorial Bursary, Sunset Country Métis Bursary, proud to be Métis. Marty is an Ontario Scholar and a recipient of the Fort Frances High School Leadership Award. Sean Allen Wider. Logan Thomas Yerksa. Daniel Maynard Kenneth Princia Young. Daniel is an Ontario Scholar.
Okay, congrats, grads. You may stand up. And on the count of three, you may choose to toss your cap. One, two, three. So this concludes our 2021 Fort Francis High School graduation ceremony. I want to thank one and all for their participation. A big thank you to the staff. A big thank you to the staff for making this a memorable, eventful graduation ceremony. In addition, I want to thank MJ Interactive, Fort Francis Times, and School Council. Thanks to everyone.
Oh, ho, ho.